Well, if you had to sum up this season in one word, you might say wow. Or how about fun? Firebirds Extra wrap-up right here live from Eldridge Park. Finishing up this season, recapping your Orleans Firebirds' splendid 2012 campaign. Kevin Fitzgerald and Sam Leavitt here, as always, here with you. And Sam, it was a roller coaster season from start to finish. The Orleans Firebirds, they finished 22-22 in the regular season. Hey, they make it all the way to the Eastern Division Finals, where they lost right here to Eldridge against those Whitey Red Sox. Man, just when you break it down, so many different storylines, so many different interesting aspects of this season. It was one great ride for these guys. The Orleans 19s is what they were really calling them towards the end. Really a close-knit group that stayed together all season long, Sam.
Well, obviously it was a roller coaster ride. I mean, it's a team that started 13-3. They ended 9-19 in the regular season, make it to the first round of the playoffs, sweep the Harwich Mariners, then lose two straight games to the YD Red Sox, but a fun ride nonetheless. And Kelly Nicholson and his coaching staff, they kept an upbeat attitude from the start of the season all the way till when they were losing players left and right towards the latter part of the season.
Yeah, certainly. Kelly's been here for a dozen years, 8th year as the head field manager, and well, he almost made it to another Cape League championship. It was a couple games short. He done just a phenomenal job this season. He talked about this team, talking about the character. From day one, he told us, Sam, hey, in terms of character, this could be the best group of guys I have in all my years here working in Orleans. Whether it was Jason Brown, Benny Craig, Robert Woodard, the whole coaching staff, they all did a splendid job with this team. And how many times do we hear these guys saying, hey, I want to come out to the park and just hear Jason Brown's story of yesteryear? Or how many times have we heard these guys say, I want to go get some advice and take extra BP with Benny Craig and Robert Woodard, who's down in UNC Wilmington now, pitching coach for that squad. Really just a great leader out here. They all did a wonderful job working with these guys. And well, so many different aspects of this season. When you look at the beginning part of the season, this team started 11-1 in the first quarter of the year. They got off to a tremendous start, a tremendous fast start, came out quick. And really, you got to look at some of these guys. Someone like Conrad Gregor led this team in hitting, hit 329 on the year. We're talking about his Gregorian at-bats and his Gregorian day, Sam, a guy who led the league in walks. He would get on base about three times a day. He would have a couple hits. He would have a walk or so. Just a player. So consistent, so patient every day, day in and day out, he's working hard.
Well, he worked harder, or as hard as anyone on this team.
Oh, yeah.
And I mean, you talk about someone always out for early work, always putting the effort in. Really, we talked about it last night, became a leader of this team, always on the top step of the dugout, cheering on his teammates, a leader in the infield, and someone who I think found himself a little bit as a player. He hit a lot of home runs, RBIs. Of course, we called his at-bats Gregorian, because every night, like you said, he just seemed to work out a walk and always doing something to help the team in a ton of great moments for him. And I mean, just a great season for him, and hopefully momentum he can take into a season at Vanderbilt.
So many positive aspects of his game. He's a great guy around the clubhouse as well. Everybody got along with him well. Really, like I was saying before, a close-knit group. As we moved along in the second quarter of the season, more and more guys started coming up from the College World Series. It wasn't just guys like Gregor or PK Kitamura or someone like Angelo Labruna. You had extra players moving up here from the College World Series, guys like Derek Toedvine, who played a lot of time out in center field and in the infield as well. Guys like pitchers, like James Ferris and Matt Troop, the Arizona guys. A lot more players kept moving their way into this roster. And really, at the deadline, the early July deadline, when Kelly finalized his roster, kept 30 guys, and he kept a couple temporary players as well, Sam. They made a big impact.
Right. Well, you talk about guys like Kevin Brown, Cody Culp, and Dylan Clark. And you talk about Brown and Culp for a second, because those were two guys, position players, that both tore it up in the early part of the season. And two guys who really worked hard and wanted to be here till the end. I mean, we saw players leave left and right, but they battled. And I think that's one thing that you could say about Kelly Nicholson and his club this season, was that no matter what adversity they faced at different points in the season, they battled all year long. And it wasn't only from start to finish, from game one to game 48, but it was game by game, the way they battled back late in games, all the walk-off wins, the one run wins, and just great stuff. And then you talk about a guy like Dylan Clark, who came in out of the bullpen and dominated, really, and it was very unfortunate to see him have to go home with an injury earlier in the season. But, you know, the temporary players, Kelly electing to keep 30 guys, a little more than I think he anticipated at the beginning of the season. But ultimately, you got guys like Culp, Brown, Clark, who just, again, battled every day. Winners. True winners.
They really were. They came here to compete. That's certainly what they wanted to do. Everybody who was here for that last out last night, right here against YD, They wanted to play every minute, every day. And that was the story of the first half of the season. Just, they were the comeback kids. Or they were the cardiac kids. They were giving Kelly Nicholson a heart attack every night, really. The seven come-from-behind wins in the seventh inning or later in the first 22 games of the season. Hey, it made for a lot of late-game drama. They had a lot of late wins, a lot of one-run games that they stuck around in, played hard, as they were really the comeback kids in the early part of the season. And a lot of that due to those temporary guys that Kelly did keep around. Like you said, Kevin Brown, Cody Culp, and Dylan Clark, whether it was out on the field, up at the plate, they all made a huge impact.
Culp started back, now comes in, dives, and makes the catch! A terrific play by Cody Culp.
He looks up, and that one's gone. A grand slam for Kevin Brown.
Firebird's extra wrap-up continues here live from Eldridge Park. It's been such a great season, and well, you just saw some of those guys making a huge impact in the field, some of those temporary players that made their full-time contracts. One of probably the biggest surprises of the season, the biggest stories in terms of surpassing expectations, was Angelo Labruna. Really, that third quarter of the season, Angelo went on an absolutely mind-boggling tear. He raised his average up over 300. The power came around. Finished with 5 home runs on the season, and most of them came in that stretch in late July towards the third quarter of this season when a guy who, hey, might not be known for his bat. Oh, man, he went on an absolute tear. The Tuke shortstop, who's been up here really all his life, Sam.
He really has. It was a great story, his relationship with Coach Kelly Nicholson, how he got onto this team, and a guy who was really a tale of two seasons. The first half, kind of light hitting, and then the second half, something clicked. And whether it was the leg kick that he worked on with Benny Craig, that little Joey Bats leg kick he had going on, but all of a sudden the power came, and then the RBIs came, and the late game dramatics came. A guy who all the way into the playoffs, into that first round against Harwich, really came up with big hit after big hit. One moment for me that's going to stick out is that 2 RBI triple in game 1 at Harwich, because that was a game that Orleans came in, they were losers of their last 5 regular season games, and it was just a hit that got the weight off their backs. You could tell just a little bit. And Angelo, such a hard worker. Again, it was a pleasure getting to know him and getting to know his parents, played in front of his family and friends every single day, and so nice to see someone who worked so hard all year long, the dividends finally showing.
Yeah, certainly. And probably the biggest, maybe one of the biggest moments of the season was, well, he had a big walk-off hit against this Whitey squad earlier in the year that was a big come-from-behind victory for the Firebirds.
Here comes Riddle around third. The throw home is not in time. And Angelo Labruna does it again for the Firebirds. And the magical ride continues for the shortstop out of Duke.
Well, you said it, Sam. Angelo got to spend this summer with his family, with his friends, a guy who came up here for the last 7, 8, 9 years vacationing up in the Cape in Orleans, and it was his dream, he told us, to play right here at Eldridge Park. He got to do that, and boy, did he ever take advantage of it. Good luck to him the rest of the way down in Duke, and you'll certainly see things from him heading forward in his baseball career. As Firebirds extra wrap-up continuing here from Eldridge Park, Kevin Fitzgerald and Sam Levitt here with you. And really, as this team kind of progressed towards the latter half and the final quarter of the season, you know, turmoil started to I guess, make its way here at Eldridge Park. A lot of guys were leaving due to injuries. The team actually limped into the playoffs on a 5-game losing streak. It really was a tough ending to the year. A team that was just decimated, decimated with the injuries. They went from 30 on the roster to 19 when it was all said and done. It's tough to manage a team when you have less than 20 players, but Kelly found a way to do so, really staring adversity in the face.
He really did, and, you know, the mantra in the playoffs and in the last part of the season, when they were struggling badly and guys were kind of leaving left and right, would shock the Cape. And I think that's something that Kelly did a great job of, and the coaching staff, Benny and Brownie, they kept the mood upbeat.
Yeah.
And the guys who were remaining, the 19 guys that were here on the final day of the season, they wanted to be here and they wanted to fight. And I think it was interesting because you also saw the evolution of the pitching staff. And we haven't really talked about the pitching just yet. You had Matt Boyd, Jared Arakawa, and Jimmy Reed, really the three-headed monster.
The three-headed monster that came around really was
going
to the playoffs.
and all of them pitched well. Obviously, Jared had a couple of injury issues throughout the season, but when he did pitch, he pitched phenomenally, and great starts by all of them. And again, you know, we haven't talked about the pitching, but truly, the pitching is what carried this team. They led the league in ERA as a staff at 3.73, a terrific year in a year in the Cape League where offense was all up all over the place and kind of an abnormal year. But the pitching staff, the bullpen, huge stories of this season, and really a reason why they were able to beat Harwich in the first round and get to the playoffs in the first place.
Cowboys.
Yeah, in a year where the home run record was shattered here in the Cape by those Harwich Mariners. They did take them down in the first round of those playoffs. Like you said, had the best pitching staff in a year of offense. Really offensive juggernauts all throughout the Cape. You mentioned the three-headed monster. They really came in as an identity, I guess. Those top three pitchers in the second half of the season, whether it was Jimmy Reed, who just found his stride in the second half. The Maryland left-hander was just really one of the best starters for this team in the latter half of the year. Matt Boyd, a guy who came in late. He came in late June and early July. This Firebirds team brought him back for a second straight summer. He had two flawless starts in the late goings of the season where he struck out 11 batters and then 12 in two back-to-back starts. It was great really working with Matt and Jared Arakawa.
And don't forget Phil Pfeiffer. Because Phil, at least in my opinion, his performance in Game 2 in Round 1 was the biggest, most clutch performance of the season. I mean, after Arakawa goes down with an injury in the first inning, he comes in, throws six phenomenal innings. And just a great start by him. And you know, hopefully maybe you see him back here next year.
Hey, Kelly even said to us, he wants Phil back. Like you said, really just a turning point in that playoff series was when Phil came in Game 2. The Firebirds, they defeated the Harwich Mariners they swept them 2-0 in the first round in these divisional playoffs. Just a big hump to get over, a big hurdle at this team climbed, unfortunately. They ran into a brick wall in the Whitey Red Sox these past couple nights right here at Eldridge Park. Is just another powerful offense in the Cape. Ended this dream run in the playoffs. The Shock the Cape, it didn't come through quite nicely as Kelly wanted, but he'll take this
season. It was a fun ride.
Just despite all of the injuries and despite losing so many players, they really surpassed expectations and made their way nicely in the playoffs. Nice finish.
They really did, and again, you know, we've said it a number of times in this wrap-up show, I guess you could call it already, is that, you know, through everything, this team battled, and the guys who were here wanted to be here. They fought hard, and they ran into a YD team that was just very, very good. They pitched well, and they hit well, and a lineup that can really swing it. And, good luck to them in the championship series. Good luck to Wareham as well. But overall, yes, a roller coaster of a ride, I guess you could say, of a 2012 season for Kelly Nicholson's club, but a fun ride. It was a lot of fun.
It certainly was. Again, they finished up 22-22 this season. They beat Harwich in the first round of the playoffs. Unfortunately, they could not get past those pesky Whitey Red Sox in the second round. And hey, for all you guys listening out there, we really appreciate all you guys sticking with us. The fans on OrleansFirebirds.com, thanks for sticking with us all season long. Firebirds Extra postgame, Firebirds Extra wrap-up, finishing up here live from Eldridge Park. For Kevin Fitzgerald, Sam Levitt here with me. Thanks for tuning in all season long. We'll see you next year from Eldridge.